Hi viewers, welcome to my channel. This is Sridhar Reddy, Assistant Professor of Physics from Government Degree College for Women, Nalgunda. Welcome to my channel, Sri Quantum Academy, Feel the Physics at Glance. Today's our topic is how to find electric field due to a conducting two-dimensional sheet and electric field due to non-conducting sheet. And also we discuss here the force acting on a charged conducting surface. Before going to watch my video, please subscribe my channel and press bell icon to get latest updates. Please share, comment, watch, like my videos. In my previous videos, we are discussing about applications of Gauss law. In that, we have discussed about the electric field due to a charged sphere and electric field due to a charged cylinder. These two are the examples for three-dimensional charge distributions. In that, we have used volume charge density. Now today I am going to discuss with you how to apply Gauss law for two-dimensional charge distribution. For two-dimensional charge distribution, examples are a conducting sheet and non-conducting sheet. Today we will discuss here the electric field due to conducting surface and electric field due to non-conducting surface, and finally we will discuss the mechanical force acting on a conducting surface. See here, this is a two-dimensional sheet. What is two-dimensional sheet? It has only length and breadth, that means only two dimensions. There is no third dimension here. Now take this two-dimensional sheet. If I rotate this two-dimensional sheet, see here, like this. Now this is rotated view. So if I observe this two-dimensional sheet in perpendicular way, this is how it looks like. This is called side view. Now this is the side view of my two-dimensional sheet. This is back side and this is front side, right? Now take this two-dimensional sheet on which Q charge is continuously distributed on the both sides of this surface. That means on two sides, back side and front side, Q charge is continuously uniformly distributed. Now identify the electric field direction. Electric field direction is always outward from the positive charge. So for front side, electric field is like this, and for back side, electric field is like this. This is the directions of electric field. Since charge is uniformly distributed, I will use surface charge density. See here, this is a conducting sheet on which Q charge is continuously distributed. Now I have to find electric field at a distance r from this sheet. See here, there is a point P1 which is at a distance r from the sheet. To find electric field at this point, what I am doing, just imagine a symmetrical point P2 which is at same distance from the sheet on the other side of the sheet, that means back side. Take this point P2 at same distance r on the back side. Now draw a Gaussian surface which is joining point P1 and P2. If you join these points, now it looks like a Gaussian cylinder, right? This is my Gaussian cylinder. Since Gaussian cylinder has three kinds of surfaces, left hand plane, right hand plane and curved surface. See here, this is left hand plane at point P2. I am taking a small area ds. Now if I draw the normal to the ds, it is shown with green color line. Now this is my ds and this is electric field. Similarly, if I take small area ds on the right hand plane, now this is my normal drawn to this surface and this is electric field. Now for curved surface, to observe curved surface, what I am doing, just I am zooming this area. So if I observe separately this area, now this is my curved surface. If I take small area ds, now this is my normal drawn to this surface. Here electric field direction is always like this, but my normal is in this direction. Now the angle between ds and E is 90 degrees. So, in three cases, for left hand plane, EDS parallel. For right hand plane, EDS parallel. But for curved surface, EDS perpendicular to each other. So, for curved surface, theta becomes 90. And for left and right hand, they are zeros. If I explain this diagram once again, consider a thin non-conducting sheet of infinite size. Q be the charge uniformly distributed throughout the sheet. The electric field is perpendicular to sheet everywhere on both sides. Let the surface charge density be the sigma. To find the electric field at point P1, which is at a distance r from the sheet, imagine another point P2 which is symmetric with P1 on the other side of the sheet as shown in figure. Imagine a Gaussian surface in the form of cylinder, one end at P1 and another end is at P2. For curved surface, electric field E is perpendicular to the surface normal. So, the contribution of electric flux is 0 because theta is equal to 90, cos 90 becomes 0. For both ends, left end and right end, electric field E and surface normal DS are parallel to each other. So, theta becomes 0. Hence, the total electric flux can be written as phi is equal to phi curve plus phi left plus phi right. But phi curve becomes 0 plus phi left plus phi right. That implies phi is equal to, what is phi? Integral EDS left plus integral EDS right. Since theta becomes 0 for left and right, so cos theta becomes 1. So, my phi is equal to integral EDS plus integral EDS. Put E outside, then phi is equal to E integral DS plus E integral DS. That implies E into integration, differentiation get cancelled. Now, I will get S only. S means surface area, but here my surface area is A. So, I will use A. Now, phi is equal to E dot A plus E dot A. That implies phi is equal to 2EA. This is equation 1. What I did, just I used normal flux formula to get this. Now, what I have to do? I have to apply Gauss law. What is Gauss law? Phi is equal to Q by epsilon naught. If surface charge density is sigma and area of cross section is A, then surface charge density sigma is equal to formula Q by A. That implies then Q is equal to sigma into A. So, from Gauss formula, phi is equal to Q by epsilon naught. What is Q? Sigma into A. So, phi is equal to sigma A by epsilon naught. This is equation 2. But what is equation 1? Phi is equal to 2EA. But from Gauss law, phi is equal to sigma A by epsilon naught. If I equate these two equations, then what I will get? Left sides are equal. So, make right sides also equal. 2EA is equal to sigma A by epsilon naught. That implies E is equal to sigma by 2 epsilon naught. AA get cancelled. Now, E is equal to sigma by 2 epsilon naught. This is electric field intensity due to a non-conducting sheet. From this equation, it is very clear that electric field intensity is independent of the distance of point. There is no R here. That means electric field intensity is constant. Next, how to find electric field intensity due to a conducting sheet? Consider a two-dimensional charged conducting sheet on which Q charge is uniformly distributed. This is the conducting sheet. Since it is a conducting sheet, electric field always resides on the outer surface of the conductor. Inside conductor, electric field is zero. So, this is the direction of electric field on the outside. Let the surface charge density is sigma and area of cross section is A. Then, sigma is equal to Q by A. Right? Now, Consider a point outside the conducting surface at P. Take small area ds. The charge within the small area ds is given by dq is equal to sigma into ds. Because sigma is equal to q by a. From that q is equal to sigma into a. That means charge is equal to surface charge density into area. Here I have taken small area ds. So my charge, small charge dq is equal to sigma into ds. What is Gauss law? Flux is equal to charge by epsilon naught. That means d phi is equal to dq by epsilon naught. That implies d phi is equal to dq. What is dq? Sigma into ds. So d phi is equal to sigma into ds by epsilon naught. If you integrate both sides, integration d phi is equal to integration sigma ds by epsilon naught. On the left side, I will get just phi. Phi is equal to, on the right side, take sigma by epsilon naught outside. Now phi is equal to sigma by epsilon naught into integral ds. Right? If I integrate ds, I will get s. What is s? Surface area. Here, I have taken A as cross-sectional area. So, my area here, A. Then what I will get? Phi is equal to sigma A by epsilon naught. This is equation 1. Right? Here, A is the cross-sectional area of the sheet. But actually, what is phi? Phi is equal to integral EDS. So, phi is equal to integral EDS is equal to what I got? Sigma A by epsilon naught. So, phi is equal to integral EDS is equal to sigma A by epsilon naught. But, phi is equal to integral EDS. Bring E outside, then what I will get? Phi is equal to E integral ds is equal to sigma a by epsilon naught. If I integrate ds, what I will get? S. What is S? Surface area. Here it is A. So, E into A is equal to sigma a by epsilon naught. A get cancelled. Then what I will get? E is equal to sigma by epsilon naught. This is the electric field intensity at a point due to conducting sheet. E is equal to sigma by epsilon naught. Here it is very clear that the electric field due to conducting surface, is E is equal to sigma by epsilon naught. For non-conducting surface, E is equal to sigma by 2 epsilon naught. That means the electric field due to non-conducting sheet is half of the electric field due to conducting sheet. Right? Next one. Mechanical pressure acting on the conducting surface. This is also called mechanical force acting on the conducting surface. See here. This is a conducting surface. Let us suppose plus Q charge is continuously distributed on this surface. If I take small area ds, the charge which is on the small area ds will experience a repulsive force because of the charge outside the ds. Because everywhere plus charge is there. One plus charge opposes another plus charge. So every charge on the surface experience a repulsive force because of the neighborhood charges. Because all the neighborhood charges are positive charges only. Now we will find that repulsive force called mechanical force experienced by this charge on the conducting surface. To understand this one, see here, this is a conducting surface over which plus Q charge is uniformly distributed throughout the outer surface of this conductor. The outer surface of this conductor is divided into two parts. One is a small area which is shown with orange color, and other one is the area other than this ds which is indicated with green color. Now plus Q charge is uniformly distributed throughout the surface. So some of the charges exist on the green color and some of the charge exists on the orange color surface.
Now, two surfaces have positive charge. There exists a Coulomb repulsive force between positive and positive. Hence, the positive charge which is on the small area ds will experience a repulsion due to positive charge
on the surface other than ds.
That repulsive force acting per unit area is defined as mechanical pressure.
Take two points P1 and P2 on either side of small area ds. P1 is outside of the conducting surface and P2 is inside the conducting surface. The electric field at point P1 is divided into two parts. The electric field produced by the charge on the small area ds, which is given by E1, and the electric field produced by the charge on the surface other than ds, which is given by E2. So, total electric field at point P1 is given by E is equal to E1 plus E2. E1 is the electric field due to small area. E2 is electric field due to other than small area, that means total remaining area. Similarly, the electric field at point P2, which is inside the surface, is also divided into two parts. One is the electric field produced due to small area ds, E1, and another one is the electric field produced due to remaining area other than ds, which is given by E2. But inside the conductor, electric field should be zero. That's why E1 and E2 are opposite directions. That's why E is equal to minus E1 plus E2. But inside conductor, electric field E is equal to 0. That implies minus E1 plus E2 is equal to 0. From that, what I can write? E1 is equal to E2. Right? So, at point P1, E is equal to E1 plus E2, which is equation 1. At point P2, E1 is equal to E2, equation 2. Now, substitute equation 2 in equation 1. That implies E is equal to E1 plus E2. E2 means E1 I can write. So, E is equal to 2E1. From that, E1 is equal to E by 2. Right? But, for a conducting surface, electric field intensity E is equal to sigma by epsilon naught. If I substitute E is equal to sigma by epsilon naught, then E1 can be written as E by 2. That means sigma by 2 epsilon naught. So, E1 is equal to sigma by 2 epsilon naught. But E1 is equal to E2. So, E is equal to E1 is equal to E2 is equal to, I can write as sigma by 2 epsilon naught. This is equation 3. Now, the charge enclosed by the small area ds is given by dq is equal to sigma into ds. What is sigma? Surface charge density, charge per unit area. For how much area I want? Ds area. So, dq is equal to sigma into ds. Now, sigma into ds is the charge which is placed in the electric field E2. What is E2? E2 is the electric field produced by other than ds area. So, now sigma ds charge is placed in electric field E2. So, from basic definition of electric field intensity, E is equal to F by Q0. From that, F is equal to E into Q0. That means, the force is equal to charge into electric field. So, F is equal to charge. How much is the charge? Sigma ds into what is electric field? E2. So, F is equal to sigma ds into E2. But actually, what is E2? E1 is equal to E2 is equal to sigma by 2 epsilon naught. That is equation 3. So, substitute that equation 3 in this equation. What I will get? F is equal to sigma by ds into E2. E2 means sigma by 2 epsilon naught. That implies F is equal to sigma into sigma, sigma square ds by 2 epsilon naught. Bring that ds this side. Now F by ds is equal to sigma square by 2 epsilon naught. Here F is force, ds is area. So force acting per unit area, which is given by mechanical pressure. So now my mechanical pressure P is equal to F by ds is equal to sigma square by 2 epsilon naught, right? This is mechanical pressure in terms of sigma. That means this is the mechanical pressure in terms of surface charge density. But electric field E is equal to sigma by epsilon naught. From that, sigma is equal to E into epsilon naught. If I substitute sigma value in P, then what I will get? P is equal to sigma square. Sigma means E into epsilon naught square by 2 epsilon naught. That implies P is equal to E square epsilon naught square by 2 epsilon naught. That implies P is equal to E square into epsilon naught, 1 epsilon naught cancel. Then E square into epsilon naught by 2. This is also mechanical pressure in terms of electric field intensity. So finally, the mechanical pressure or mechanical force acting on a conducting surface is given by P is equal to sigma square by 2 epsilon naught or epsilon naught E square by 2. Thank you. Thank you very much. Please watch, share, comment, like my videos. Thank you.